Hello, YouTube. Since it's been like 2 weeks since I made my last video, I thought I would come on here and say hello and let you all know that I'm alive and I'm breathing and that all is well. So, yep. Bye. No, I'm just kidding. Just kidding. But yeah, I'm doing well compared to my last video when I was beating myself up and things like that. That happens a lot with people with depression. You feel this overwhelming guilt and what is that? Oh, you just feel like this overwhelming guilt, and you know what I'm talking about. But no, I'm doing well. What day is it? Calendar says it's September 17th. Is that right? Is it the 17th? All the days run together for me, so I guess so. But yes, I'm doing good. I am. And I just wanted to give a little update and say, and just update and say, hey, how's it going? So, hold on. My husband, God bless him. He's one of the hardest working people I know. He recently had went 5 weeks without any time off. Like his job, I mean, he's been so busy. He didn't even get his weekends off. And so he told them last weekend, he was like, I need to have my Saturday and Sunday, okay? Because this week, like the week we're currently in, it's what they're going through at work is called Hell Week. And he's like, if I'm gonna go through that, then I need my weekend. Give me my weekend. So he was able to finally get a full weekend off this past weekend. And of course, it went by so quickly. And so now him and his other coworkers are in what's known as Hell Week at his warehouse. And that just means they're gonna be Hell Week is just nothing more than them being extremely super duper booper busy. And it's very stressful for them and things like that. So his current schedule right now is they got him working from like 3 p.m. until 1 a.m. And I don't know. I don't know. He's so far, he's been okay. He's been okay with that schedule, but I don't know how long that's gonna before he flips out. I don't know how long it's gonna last. But because he's such a hard worker, what we do is like if he ever gets a day off, we'll take him to like the mall and he'll get like one of those like 12-minute chair massages by those Asian folks or whatever, that are in the mall. We'll do that. Or like this past weekend, we went to Sport Clips. Normally he gets his hair cut at Great Clips because it's cheaper. But we went to Sport Clips this past Sunday. Yes, because I wanted him to be pampered. And so he got the full treatment. He got like the he got his hair cut and his beard trimmed and he got a hot towel around his face and he got a neck and back massage. Because I mean he deserves it. I mean he's just so he deserves all that. He deserves more. I mean, I'll massage his feet for him when he gets home from work. So, but yeah. Okay. So that's my husband. Oh, speaking of that, 2 weekends ago, I think it was, we went to the movies and saw, well, we were just walking around the mall and I was like, hey, you want to go see a movie? And he's like, yeah, let's go see what's up and playing. And so we went and got tickets to see the Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark movies. Now, personally, I think the books were better. Like, I mean, I grew up reading them over, when I was younger, over and over and over. And you can even get them now. I've seen them at Target for like $7 a piece. We should have got them when we went to Target, but we didn't. But, excuse me. But I thought the movie in general was, it was okay. Me, I prefer to, excuse me. I prefer to be literally scared out of my mind. And it had a few jump scares, but nothing that like, kept me awake at night. And my husband does not like scary movies. He did see that and he's like, okay, that one was okay. But he was like he won't go see It Chapter Two with me. I can't wait to go see It Chapter Two. I don't know when I'm gonna go see it and who I'm gonna go see it with, but I can't wait to see it. It was okay. The movie was okay. The acting was really good. They got some really good actors in Scary Stories, so that was good. Oh, guys, I mean, I said this on Twitter, but like the other day, I was taking a nap, right? And sorry, I keep looking over. I just I never know what's in my backyard. Okay. So anyway, I was taking a nap and all of a sudden I felt this searing, God, awful pain in this finger right here. This, my fourth, my ring finger on my left hand. Right. And, I didn't open my eyes. I thought, I didn't know if I was dreaming or if it was real life, but I didn't open my eyes, but I took my right hand and I went like this real fast off of my left hand and threw whatever it was on the floor. Right. And I didn't, like I said, I didn't know if I was still dreaming or what, and I still had my eyes closed, but then the searing pain got even worse in this finger. And so I opened my eyes finally, and I looked on the floor and I saw this blurry black thing, and I'm like, God, what is that? And so I put my glasses on and I look, and it was a black wasp. A black wasp stung my ring finger, y'all. And so I took my husband's shoe, because his shoes are heavier than my shoes, and I killed it and disposed of its carcass. And but for like an hour, I mean, I had just excruciating pain in that finger, and it was horrible. I was just like, ow, you know, even running it under cold water and stuff like that. And then for the rest of the day, though, I really couldn't bend that finger without having a lot of pain. So, but I'm fine now. I'm not allergic or anything. I'm not. So that reminds me of one time when we lived in Germany, right? I was at the base exchange. I was standing in the checkout line at the base exchange, and I heard this commotion behind me. I don't know what was going on. I normally just keep to myself and don't pay attention to what's going on. And all of a sudden I felt this God awful pain in my right palm, like right here. And I was like, what the fuck is that? And someone was like, oh, it's a yellow jacket. And I was just like, what? I don't even remember now, but I was like, I think I curled my hand up and I threw it on the ground, but it flew away. But yeah, I got stung by a yellow jacket in the palm of my right hand. And I think that hurt because I could not literally use that hand for like 2 days. It was so painful. But I'm not allergic to any of that stuff, so that's good. What else? I have like a little thing here. I guess that's those three things that are. As far as my depression goes, yeah, I still have depression. Yep. I am still taking my 40 milligrams of Prozac. I need to get a refill on that, actually. I have not seen my psychiatrist this month. I'm just going to hold off until October 9th. I'll be fine. So my sleeping pattern has been really weird, and I haven't been taking my trazodone because I don't feel that it's necessary right now. But like the past week or so, I've been getting up at night, or like waking up, going back to sleep, waking up, going back to sleep. You know, you get the picture. And it doesn't interrupt my sleep. I don't wake up feeling just downright exhausted because of that. But I've been doing, that's what's been happening, is I've been waking up, going back to sleep, waking up, going back to sleep. I don't know why, but so there's that. But it doesn't affect, it's not affecting me too bad. So yeah. What else is going on, you guys? What else? I don't know. I guess that is it for now. But I did, when I noticed that it's been like 2 weeks since I made my last video, I just wanted to come on here and say hello and that I am alive. I am breathing. I am doing awesome as best as I can. I hope you guys are all doing fabulous. And I will talk to you all later. Thank you for all the new subscribers I have received. This blessing. I know that sometimes I repeat myself, and I'm sorry. I don't have any editing software just yet, but maybe in the future I will get some and we'll be able to make better YouTube videos. So until then, I will let you all go and see you later. Bye-bye.